The first contact that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam he had with jinns is when he went to the Ta'if. He went to the Ta'if because the people in Mecca were giving him a hard time and they've rejected his call. So he went, especially after his uncle died and Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. He went to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he was rejected. And they sent the slaves and the kids to run after him and to throw stones at him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to ease the pain that our beloved Prophet, peace be upon him, has gone through. As he was coming back to Mecca, he said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he started to pray. And a group of jinns came. While he was praying sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was reciting the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what happened. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, and we sent forward to you group of jinn, they were hearing the Quran. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Subhanallah, these group of jinns, the shaitan has commanded the jinns to find out what is happening. Because at that time, the jinns weren't able to hear any information from the heavens. So the shaitan said, go around. Something has to happen on the face of the earth for us not to be able to hear what's happening. What are the angels talking about? They were casted with fire. Every time they want to hear a conversation amongst the angels, they were casted. They were basically blocked and shielded. So the shaitan has said to the jinns, go and find out. Something must have happened.
What used to happen before the coming of the Prophet ﷺ, the jinn, they used to hear the news from the angels. So basically when the Prophet ﷺ came, you know, his message, the jinn could no longer hear what was happening on the news from the heavens.
So this group of jinns, Nusaybin, they were roaming around and they heard our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam reciting the Quran.
There's a hadith in Bukhari reported by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he was with the Prophet alayhi wasallam, and then the Prophet went, you know, a little further, and then Abdullah said, when he saw it, he saw the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, there were some people who were some different creations gathering around the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, gathered around him so much so that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud could not see the Prophet alayhi salam. So Abdullah moved and he went to see, you know, the Prophet, see what's happening to him. The Prophet alayhi salam gave a sign to Abdullah to stay back. These were the jinn who came, you know, asking the Prophet alayhi salam about al-Islam, and they embraced Islam. So this is the first acquaintance of jinn, and these were the jinn from Nusaybin, the city called Nusaybin. The city is called Nusaybin, it's in Sham.
When they heard the Quran, they ran to their people. They ran and informed them about the Quran.
They went to warn their people. Their people from what? From jinn. قالوا يا قومنا, oh my قوم, إنا سمعنا كتابا أنزل من بعد موسى مصدقا لما بين يديه يهدي إلى الحق وإلى طريق مستقيم. يا قومنا أجيبوا داعي الله وآمنوا به.
They said, oh people, oh our people, we heard a book descended after Musa, because they used to believe in Musa. Subhanallah al-Azim.
What a beautiful Quran. يهدي إلى الرشد. فآمنا به. We believed it. ولن نشرك بربنا أحد. Look what they say about those who say Allah has a son. What is it? وأنه تعالى جد ربنا. وأنه كان يقول سفيهنا على الله شطط. سفيه. The foolish. The one who said this. شوف الجن. How they react to somebody who says Allah has a son. Huh? Foolish.
At the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some of them used to believe in Jesus, and some used to believe in Moses and Ibrahim, as there used to be people at that specific time. Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's informing us of what has happened. There are jinns who have adhered to what you have said, and they have accepted your da'wah. And that is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to all mankind and jinns. Subhanallah, this book, it confirms the same message as Musa. Subhanallah al-Azim. They all came from the right source, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at-Tawrat. That's why Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ. Woe to those that write the book in their hands, and then they say it's from Allah, so they can buy something which is insignificant. How many people that we hear these days, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, they write the book and they say it's from Allah. How many different Bibles that exist out there? How many different versions of the Bible? There's one Quran. Far east, far west, north, south. One Quran everywhere in the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has preserved this Quran. So these jinns, when they heard the glorious Quran, the beautiful recitation of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they went to their people and conveyed their message. يَهْدِي إِلَى الْحَقِّ وَإِلَى طَرِيقٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. They said, this Quran guides to what is true.